Good morning, children. How are you all? Okay. Today we are going to discuss minerals and mining. Lesson number 6, minerals and mining. So, what are the minerals? Before going to the topic, just you look around your house. What are the walls? You see, walls were constructed with the mud, cement, joined with the cement, mud, sand, everything, isn't it? And after that, there is a whitewash. Is it a lime wash? And if you see the floor, there are granites, marbles, granites, red stone, shapa stone, like that different stones we are carved with the stones. So all these things from where we get them? Said those are nothing but minerals. Okay, these minerals, so what is a mineral? What is the definition of mineral? Generally in science, geologists define minerals as a homogeneous, naturally occurring substance with a definable internal structure. It's very tough, no? Little bit. Okay. If it is science, you say this definition. But in social, no need of saying all the situation definition. In other words, very simple definition. Almost anything we obtain naturally from the earth. Almost anything we obtain naturally from the earth. From the earth, which is not in the form of animal or plant, which is not in the form of any animal or plant, whatever obtained from the earth is called mineral. Okay. So, a simple definition for the mineral is almost anything which we obtain naturally from the earth, which is not animal or plant, that is called a mineral. Okay. So, minerals are also generally classified in a general purpose and commercial purpose. They classified into three basic things. Okay, minerals are classified into three types. What are that? First one is metallic minerals. Second is non-metallic minerals. And the third one is energy minerals. What are that? Energy minerals. So when you see the examples, you can easily understand. Again, in the metallic minerals, there are two types again. Ferrous based and non-ferrous based. What is meant by ferrous based? You have learned in physics, I think. Non-ferrous based. That means nothing but ferrous based means those are iron is in, including iron here is called ferrous based, and non-ferrous based, they are not included iron. So what are these? Ferrous based metallic minerals are iron ore, manganese, nickel, etc. Ferrous based. And non-ferrous based are bauxite, copper, lead, these are non-ferrous based. So, then you go to the non-metallic minerals. What are non-metallic minerals? For example, just now I said about the granite. Granite, mica, marble, limestone. These are all non-metallic minerals. In this metallic, iron will not be involved. Next, energy minerals. What are the energy minerals? You all know that. Coal, petroleum and petroleum products like kerosene, all. And gases, natural gas, these are all considered energy minerals. So, minerals are classified for the general purpose. They are classified into two, three types of metallic minerals, non-metallic minerals, and energy based minerals. So again, in the metallic minerals, there are two types, ferrous based and non-ferrous based. The ferrous based are iron ore, manganese, nickel, and non-ferrous based is bauxite, copper, lead, etc. And non-metallic minerals are granite, mica, marble, okay, and limestone. These are all considered non-metallic. And energy based minerals are coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. Okay. So here again there are two things are there: renewable energies and non-renewable. sources and non-renewable sources. Environmentalists differentiate between the two kinds of minerals, that is renewable and non-renewable. Renewable and non-renewable. What is non-renewable? Which will be generate again, which will be regenerate, that means reuse. For example, when you cut it here for wood and after to another place, if you keep one more plant, then what happens generally, the other plant in after some years you will eat some wood from the other plant, isn't it? Like that we can regenerate, that reuse even water, plants and all, these are renewable energies. When you see non-renewable energy, in the same way, if a big granite rock is there. So when you cut that granite rock and you take all the stones and use for a building purpose and all, again you can you keep one more granite rock in some other place? No, it is once it is exhausted, it will be exhausted. It will not regenerate, it will not use it again. Then that is called non-renewable resources. Okay, we'll see some more examples with the renewable and non-renewable. They are in the textbook also. If you want, you can see. Otherwise, see my table. See the renewable resources and non-renewable resource and minerals. He asked for something, example. So first you have to say tick. If it is mineral, you tick it. If it is not mineral, you just strike it off like this. And it is a renewable or non-renewable. For example, take bamboo. Bamboo is a renewable or non-renewable or mineral? Bamboo is not a mineral and renewable. Bamboo is a renewable. So you have to write here bamboo in a renewable resource column. Okay, renewable resource column. And here it is not mineral, that's why you have to strike it off like this. Okay, we'll see the second. Coal. What is coal? Coal, once you use it, it will be exhausted, isn't it? Coal, once you use it, you cannot use it because the ash will come with the coal once it is exhausted. We can't do it again. Yeah, ash cannot change as coal, isn't it? So, once exhausted, exhausted. That's why whatever minerals found in the earth are slowly, very fastly, these are all exhausting. Every day we are digging so many mines and all. So, after some period of time, what happens? They will be completely exhausted. So, what is the other alternative for that? That's why we have to take care of this non-renewable resources. And we have to see the other alternatives also. For example, and take coal. Once upon a time, in the before independence and after independence also, the trains used with the coal only, like coal trains only. But coal mines are exhausted once, then we have seen the electricity. We go for the electricity, one more non-renewable energy, and again with electricity. Now in India totally it is electrified, isn't it? Trains are running with the totally electrified. But the thing is, how for even electricity also? For the electricity also we need water, isn't it? We have to generate hydroelectricity. Again water is needed. So and water also if it exhausted, so we have to see the minerals very carefully. And very sustainably we have to use the minerals. Next is coal. Coal is a non-renewable resource. And here this is the right, because coal is a mineral. Okay. And the third thing is seawater. Seawater is a renewable, isn't it? Seawater is a renewable and this is not mineral. And fourth one, ants. Ants are regenerating. Okay. So ants is a regenerating, it's not mineral. Okay, next is fishes, or you can see trees also, tree also, it's a renewable resource and it's not a mineral. like that mud, cement. Here non-renewable resources, mud, sand, petroleum, diamonds, marble, everything. For example, we are using ornaments like gold and silver. Gold also in our whole world, the gold, whatever mineral is found, that is very less. Nowadays that is decreasing, that is getting exhausted. Once we dig it, it is exhausted. So there is no other, for gold there is no other alternative also, isn't it? Like that, once the exhausted materials are called minerals. Then we go over, let us see some more important minerals. How the minerals are using, what per year they are using in a daily life and all. You take, let us take an example of mineral is formed of iron ore. What is this ore? Generally, where the minerals are usually found in the ores. What is meant by ore? Ore is nothing but it is described as accumulation of any mineral mixed with the other element. That means ore means it's not pure. For example, you take iron ore. In iron ore means in that it's a mixed with the other elements also. Maybe other copper, zinc or anything, it is mixed with the iron. So then it is iron ore. We can call it as a iron ore. Like that, what is the definition? The term ore is used to describe an accumulation. The term ore is used to describe an accumulation of any mineral mixed with other element. That means it is not pure, impurity, other elements. Okay. So the term ore is used to describe an accumulation of any mineral mixed with the other elements. Then it is called ore. Like that, iron ore, when we are talking about, let us begin there. First mineral, that is iron ore. See, India is fairly rich in iron ore. We have almost in all parts of India, we are very practically found in all parts of the country. In India, almost all the part of the country, iron ore deposits are found. India is the fourth largest producing country in the world. Largest iron ore producing country. So definitely you will have a doubt. So this is the fourth largest. What are the remaining? So first largest country of iron ore is Australia. Second is Brazil. Third is China. Fourth is India. And fifth is Russia. See, actually in India, we have more than 100 minerals. We are very much plentily available. But the thing is, these minerals are exhaustible minerals. So if you keep on digging like that, it may, in the some period of time, it will be exhausted definitely, isn't it? So the fourth largest iron ore producing country is India. Remaining three are, first one is Australia, second is Brazil, world's largest iron ore producing, and third is China, and fourth is India, and fifth is Russia. And in India, so first, why, actually if any mineral if you take, so how to read regarding that? So where it is found, in the world what is the India's rank, okay, and what are the other countries' rank? 1 to 5, first 5, what are the other countries rank, and what is the use of that mineral, where it is using, and in India, in which places it is found a lot, plentily it is found. So all these things we have to learn about one mineral. Okay. Then in major iron ore belts in India, major iron ore belts in India are major iron ore belts in India. Iron ore belts in India are they are Ballari, Chitradurg belt, Ballari belt, and Tumkur and Chikmagalur. Tumkur belt and Chikmagalur. This is one belt of iron ore, biggest belt. And next, Odisha belt in Jharkhand. Odisha belt in Jharkhand belt. And Durga Bastar and Chandrapur. So like this, these are number of major iron ore belts. Even in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana also we have more. In Andhra Pradesh more iron ore belts are there. One is Vishakhapatnam, Vijayanagaram. So these are all we are detailing, we will learn about. And next, there are so many minerals like that. Manganese, copper, lead, okay, zinc, bauxite. So renewable metallic minerals and non-metallic minerals and renewable resources like that, we can learn many things about this. And these are the important states of India. Karnataka is one of the important iron ore belt, and Jharkhand, Karnataka is producing one fourth iron ore for Indian domestic purpose, iron ore within India. So we are generally, if it is plenty, generally all minerals are three categories. One is rich minerals. We have a lot of minerals. Rich minerals means that is sufficient to our needs in India, within India, and also we can export. We can export to our countries or other countries also. That is plenty. If it is plenty, we can do like that. If it is average, then what we will do within country purpose only we will use. And if it is deficient means it is not even sufficient for Indian domestic purpose. India, within India only we are not able to survive that minerals, then that is deficit minerals. So plenty minerals, average minerals, and deficit minerals. So for example, you take copper is completely deficient in India, isn't it? Copper and petroleum are very much deficient in India, and we are importing from other countries. Exporting means we are sending to other countries. Importing means we are getting from other countries. Okay. So petroleum and copper are little deficient to our countries. So we are importing from other countries. So this is about iron ore. And next we'll discuss in tomorrow's class we'll discuss the other important minerals. Thank you, children. I hope everyone understood.